Okay, right. Okay, welcome to engineering drawing class. Today we are going to solve one problem on perspective projections. Right. The problem is a hexagonal pyramid of base side 25 mm and the axis length 50 mm is resting on GP ground plane on its base with a side of base inclined at 30 degree to PP. The nearest corner to PP is 20 mm behind it. The station point is 60 mm above GP and 80 mm in front of PP and lies in a central plane which is 50 mm to the left of the axis of the pyramid. Draw the perspective view of the pyramid. I have given the introduction part. Now we are going to draw the perspective for this particular. This is the hexagonal pyramid. How we are going to draw the perspective? Here the condition, it is resting on its GP with one of the side of the base is inclined at 30 degree. One of the side of the base is inclined at 30 degree. This is the position we please try to understand. So here the steps are, I am going to give. What are the steps? Right here. So first we start with the step number 1. I will write here the steps also. Right. Step number 1. 1. Draw PP. PP is nothing but picture plane. Then ground line and horizontal line. Three things we need to draw first. For which, first I am going to have here. So, this is a record. Right? This is my PP line. This is my what? PP, picture plane. Then I will have one ground plane also. Ground plane is bottom one. I like to keep like this. This is my ground plane. Right? This is my ground plane. This is my ground plane. So, here we have this distance between this ground plane or ground line and PP is somewhat the distance of 80 plus 60, 140, more than this 140 millimeter you like to keep here, right? Now I am going to draw the first, second step is draw top view, draw top view. Top view is drawn because in this perspective projection we are going to use the third angle projection method. So I am going to keep like this. This is the object. Here one is 30 degree to HP. So here I need to mark one point, right? Here the nearest corner to PP is 20 mm. This is my nearest corner. This is the my nearest corner point. It is 20 mm behind this PP. Now I am going to draw the top view of this particular pyramid, right? Top view of, in third angle, the top view will be drawn above the front view. That is the idea, right? Already we know that, right? Now I am going to complete this. This is my top view of this hexagonal pyramid. Now I will mark here the points. This is my point O. Now we need to join these points. We need to join these points. I am going to give the name for these particular things. This is my corner point A, B, C, D, E and F. So, I have completed the reference line. Here, additional reference line. This is, I call this PPX. So, before that we need to locate this station point, right? We turn the top view here, this side, this nearest corner is, what is given? The nearest corner is 20 mm behind that. So I marked here, right? The station point is 60 mm above HP and 80 mm in front of EP. Lies in a central plane which is 50 mm to the left of the axis of the plane. Which is 50 mm to the left of the axis of the pyramid. This is the axis of the pyramid. So the station point will be 50 mm from this. This is the axis. Now leave 50 mm here. Then you can draw one line through which you can have this particular, this is I call the CP line, central plane. In the central plane, you can take this 80 mm in front of VB, right? 80 mm in front of VB, you can mark here. This is my point, I call this E. E is the top view point of I, right? Now I need to join this point with all the corner points. For example, A with E. A with this E point. Then B with this E point. Then C with this point. I want to connect all these corner point with this top view point of this station point, right? With the center also I need to draw. I need to draw the center point also, right? So this is the way I need to connect this one, right? I need to draw here. Okay, right? I need to mark all these points. Understand? This is the station point. Now I am going to use the side view method. So for which I need one auxiliary plane, reference plane. I will call this PPE. This is called PPE. I will call this what? PPE. E is nothing but end or side view. For which now I am going to draw the side view for this hexagonal pyramid. This is the first point. This is for the second point. This is for the third point. And this is for the fourth point. And this is corresponding to center. Now I need to draw 45 degree from all these corner points. 45 degree line. Then I get this. All these lines should be drawn 45 degree. Now I will project from the first center line, right? This is my center line. We need to project here, right? This is going to be the axis line. This is one point, right? We need to draw this. We will mark here and another line we need to draw. So here we are going to use the side view. Similarly, you can have the front view also method. There are two methods. One is the you can use this top view and front view. This is the second method, top view and side view is used for obtaining the perspective view. We got here these points are marked here. This A point comes here, so I will mark it as what? This point I marked as A double dash. And this point I F is come here, this is I marked as F double dash. Then this is the point I marked as B double dash. Then this is the point I marked as C double dash. Then we have the P double dash and the T double dash. And A double dash and we have the C double dash. All these, sorry, E double dash. All these points I marked here. In the center line, I have the height of the pyramid is given as how much? 50 millimeter. In the center line, I am going to mark here, this is my height. This is O double dash. I need to join now O double dash with F dash, this line. And O double dash with A double dash. And O double dash with B double dash. And O double dash with C dash. Now you connect the bottom one. This is my side view of this particular solid. I kept this the same solid. I drawn the corresponding top view, whose side view we are going to see in this direction. That side view is drawn accordingly here. This is the side view. Now I want to mark another line, that is E dash. E dash is actually E dash is front view point, that is 60 mm above ground plane. 60 mm above ground plane. So from this central plane itself, we need to have. This is CP line. From bottom, I need to mark. This is my E dash point. This distance is actually how much? This distance is 60 mm above H. Now my purpose is to join E dash with O dash. I will get one incline line, and E dash with this base point. All the base points I need to join, because I want these piercing points, that is the meeting points, right? So here I want to mark the meeting points in the PP line, and this is PPE line. I want to mark the piercing points, one in the PP line. This is the first point for A1. Then this is B1. This point is F1. This is O1. This is going to be E1. And this is C1. This is D1. So I mark the piercing points. How we mark piercing point? The top view is connected with E. E is the station point top view. Then the piercing points we marked in PP. Similarly, the side view is connected with E dash. E dash is the front view of station point. We need to connect this. It fears at somewhere at PPE. That point is another point. Now I will mark here. This is my O2. And this first one is my F2. Second point is I will mark it as A2. Second point is my A2 and E2. Right? And the third point is my B2, T2. And the last point is my C2. So I mark these points. First step, I want to draw these perspective projections, for which from O1 I draw one vertical line. First, from O1 I draw one vertical line. From O2 here, this is the O2 point, I draw one horizontal line. Both will meet at some point. That point is I call this what? O, capital O, this point. Then I draw vertical line from A1. I want to draw vertical line from A1 and horizontal line from A2. This is my A2. This point is I call this what? Capital A. Capital A. Then from B1, I want to draw vertical line. So you can take the 2H pencil for drawing this. And from this B2 point, from B2, I want to draw horizontal line. This point is, I will mark as capital B. Then from, this is F1, draw the vertical line from F1 and draw the horizontal line from F2. Both will meet at some point. This point I will mark it as what? F, capital F. Then draw vertical line from E1. This is my point E1. And here this is E2. E1 and E2 is to be met at somewhere. That point is I marked as what? Capital E. That point is I marked as what? Capital E. Then from C1. The next point is C1. From C1 I will draw the vertical line. Right? From C1. And from C2, I draw the horizontal line, right? This meeting point I will call as capital C. Capital C. Then draw the vertical line from this V1, right? And the horizontal line from this T2. It is to be extended. This point is I call as capital D. So I got the base points right. That is the first base point. This is A, B, Z, D, E and F. Sorry, F is, A is coming here. This is A. A, B, C, D, E, F. And O is the top point. Now I need to join this bottom base corners first. You will get some excellent shape. You will get some excellent shape. This is going to be my bottom base of this my hexagon in perspective. So you get the bottom I have hexagon. Now I need to join with these outer sides. All the sides we need to join. Now you get this perspective view of this hexagonal pyramid. So outer side we need to join, the inner side we need to draw as a dotted line, because these are the inside portions. It is simply drawn as a dotted line, right? It is not fully visible. So I need to draw this line as the dotted one, because the A and F, F and E, and E and D, these base edges are drawn dotted line. This is to be connected to O, also dotted line. This is connected with O as dotted line. This is my perspective view. This is my perspective view of this particular pyramid, of hexagonal pyramid. Here we used this. What views we used? We used top view and side view. We used the top view and the side view for drawing this perspective projection. Quickly I will go through the things for your understanding. What is the things given? The object is hexagonal pyramid of side 25. Axis 50 is resting on ground plane with a side of base inclined at 30 degree to PP. So in the first paragraph we need to understand, we need to draw the top view of this hexagonal pyramid from this PP line, right? Here we have the 10 steps, right? So the step number 3, first step, you draw the PP line, ground line, and this E dash point is I call as HL line. Then second step, you draw the top view. Then third step, you need to draw, mark station point E, station point, and join E with top view. We need to join this top view with this station point E. This is the top view of this station point. Then fifth step, mark this piercing point. Mark piercing points. What are the piercing points we have in this PP line? We need to mark. Then step number 6, we need to draw this PPE and get the draw the side view of pyramid. Side view of pyramid. For getting this side view, in order to draw the side view, we can draw the horizontal lines from here and draw the 45 degree incline line. It is to be projected and take this height of the pyramid as the 50 millimeter. You get this side view. Then now we locate E dash point. E dash is nothing but front. This is E dash point. It is 60 millimeter above GB. That is the front view of station point. Now we are going to join this E dash with this side view. Now we get the mark piercing points. Here also we need to mark piercing points. So we have the piercing points A1, B1, C1 on PP line and A2, B2, C2 on this PPE line. Now project piercing points and mark ABCD. Mark the point ABCD to F. So draw the vertical line from A1, draw the horizontal line from A2. Similarly, B1, B2, all these points is to be marked. Then we need to connect in the order. You get the perspective view of this particular frame made. We have the 10 steps, right? Okay. This is the actual object. This is the same object, right? Is we drawn here. But you will get some little more height. Then it will be looks like the perspective view of this particular frame. Okay. Thanks for watching this video.